While in the United States, overdraft fees are down, saving Americans billions of dollars, which is beautiful. You know, holding these banks accountable. I remember when I was 19, I went to buy a fountain soda for 99 cents. I put it on my card. I didn't have enough money. I know I didn't even have a dollar in my account. I was young. I got hit with the overdraft fee, 30, 35 bucks or something. I've spent so much money like you guys probably on fees, and banks got bailed out years ago in USA. And anyway, what I'm trying to say is at least the USA is trying to fix itself. What you guys are going to see what's happening in Australia is insane. It's almost like they're deliberately trying to push people to a cashless society. And we do know cash is king. But now they're making it harder. Let me show you what Australia is doing. This is ridiculous.
The largest bank will start charging customers for withdrawing their own money. Commonwealth Bank has announced it'll slug customers $3 for taking out cash at its branches, post offices, or by phone.
Wait a second. You're going to charge people $3. They put the money in your bank. You use that money. You loan it out to people. And, you know, if I put it there, I make the interest on the money. And I guess what I'm saying is it's not like you're at a mall at a random ATM. We understand a service charge, a service fee. But charging me $3 to go to an ATM at a bank that it's not like I'm at Wells Fargo and I'm going to Bank of America to use my Wells Fargo card. I get it. I didn't put my money in your bank, but I'm coming to your bank to get some money. Yeah, I'm going to have to. I get it. But this makes no sense, folks.
Despite insisting it has no plans to go cashless.
It has no plans to go cashless, but stuff like this kind of pushes people to go cashless. How does it push people to go cashless? If I have to go to my bank physically to get money, there's nowhere else you can go. You're always hit with a fee. You go to an ATM at the mall, you go to a different bank, you go to your own bank, you're getting hit with a fee. Most people, you know, they don't just have money to waste like that. That's a waste. So yeah, maybe I won't be going and pulling out cash. I'll just use it on the card. I won't go grab it physically because I don't want to get hit with a fee wherever I go. This is what?
It comes as the company reveals it spent $410 million on cash services last financial year.
Okay, whatever. Who cares how much money you spend? It sounds like a personal problem. Sounds like a personal problem for the Commonwealth. Dude, what is going on here? Wait. Look. Dude, this is ridiculous. I'm sorry. This is straight up ridiculous. Comment below. What do you think, folks? Commonwealth Bank, $3 cash withdrawal fee, a kick in the gut, assistant treasurer. Yeah, it is. It's shameful. It's disrespectful. It's shameful. This is a kick in the gut for ordinary Australians and the worst Christmas present imaginable. Commonwealth Bank has to rethink this terrible decision. This seems to me a tax on Australians who demand the right to use their cash and the government won't stand for it. The issue may be draw attention to those bank customers who already pay assisted withdrawal fees, including those with smart access transaction accounts. Australians typically use a transaction account for day-to-day banking, such as paying bills and receiving wages. The CBA changes come as a time of intense political and public focus on living costs and growing angst about fees. You guys, all the problems in the world can all be take it back down to the root, down to greed. Man-made greed. 99.9% of all the issues across the whole globe is greed. Wealthy people wanting more money. They're hoarding their wealth, turning the common man against each other. So the Commonwealth, I'll tell you, go ahead and turn it sideways and stick it straight up your candy you know where. What do you guys think? Comment below. Thank you for watching the Off Topic Show. This has been a little update. Hit like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and help support independent content creators such as myself. And go to stayhighlypositive.com for the official Off Topic Show merchandise. And I'm not going to lie. I'm not even in Australia, but this pisses me off. Makes me want to pop a damn blood vessel. No, seriously, this ain't cool, dude. The ones that get impacted the most are the ones at the bottom. You know what I mean? It's always like that. Yet again, common man getting screwed by the Commonwealth.